My name is Julian Baseman. I'm on the lightweight men's rowing team here at the University of Delaware, and today we're talking about the engineering of rowing.
Rowing is a very interesting sport from a biomechanics perspective. You think about rowing and you think, oh man, it's got to be all about the arms and the upper body, but really rowing is a lot about the legs and the core. So there are four phases to the rowing stroke. There's the catch, which is when the oars actually engage in the water, and the key there is keeping the oars perpendicular so that you can actually catch as much water as possible as you're completing the drive, which is actually moving the oar through the water. Again, the primary from the rower's perspective where you're gonna feel the burn is in your legs, right? Because it's most of your power is coming from your legs, then your core, then the arms at the very end. So the arms are really about finishing the stroke, which is called the finish, and moving that oar up out of the water, which is a feathering motion. Then you move the oar forward on what's called the recovery. The seat in a rowing boat, in a racing shell, is actually on tracks, and that allows you to move relative to the boat, so you're not depending on boat speed and as far as how fast your oars can drive through the water. And so if you're watching the rowing at the Olympics and you see these rowers, they look like it's no effort at all, right? It's no effort at all. And then they get to the finish line, you see them completely collapse over their oars because it actually was full effort, and part of that effort is making yourself so precise in your motions and so coordinated in your motions that it looks like no effort at all. So it's very confusing when you're watching rowing because it's actually the most painful sport in the whole wide world.